There's some random clips from like day 4 and 5. Those 2 days were kind of pretty average days and whatnot. I was having trouble trying to figure out how I was gonna get home. I had to take a bus, and we're kind of like, oh, what's the biggest, you know, what city can I take a bus in, basically? And it ended up being Saint-Jérôme, which is the where we were on day 4 at when we stopped, and we actually slept in Saint-Jérôme. And the next morning, I went and kind of like figured information about the buses and stuff. And so day 5, really, like after the skate, we ended up in Joliette, Quebec, which is kind of like northeast of Montreal. And I took a bus home from there, but I kind of figured out like within, you know, like day 3, day 4, that Rob just skates faster than me, and I don't understand how, because he had been skating for so long, but basically I would set out a couple minutes before him, and then usually what would happen is I'd kind of be going at a slower pace, and then he'd kind of pass me halfway through, so I kind of like knew that I wasn't losing anybody. Because when you don't see the man for a little bit, you kind of start asking yourself questions, but kind of my way of gauging how far I was in the 10K was how much water I had left, basically. Usually once I was out of water, I pretty much got to the van, so it was a pretty good way of gauging how much further I had to go. But kind of near the end, I started skating fast enough that kind of Rob and I would get to the van at the same time, or I'd get there right before him. And really, day 1, day 2, day 3, I was getting progressively worse and worse. And I remember the night we were skating in Montreal, and I was like, I'm so tired. Like that day, I think it was really hard for me to finish that last 10K. Like it took Rob kind of pushing me and being like, you want to do the 10? And like, okay, we'll do it. And day 4 morning, I was stretching like... I was stretching in the apartment as soon as I woke up, pretty much, and I was just stretching in the van, all that stuff, so I was like, I don't know if I'm gonna make it through this day. And actually day 4 was kind of like, I felt like day 2, and then day 5 I was fine, like I felt like I could keep going, so, which is pretty crazy. It kind of showed me like how much I can do, like what I'm capable of, and that's, I don't know, it's like an experience I can't really like put a price on, even though like I had to quit my job and drop all this stuff. It's something I'm super happy that I did, and I would do it all over again, and I just want to keep staying involved with Skate for Cancer pretty much. So Erin asked me to do some video stuff for her, kind of. I think I filmed all of it on day 5 actually. So I got a couple of rolling almond shots. I put together a little video for her, but I really wish that I had more, more time to film more stuff. Like I thought I would still be there for 6th day, and so I wouldn't skate that day and pretty much just film her doing the photo stuff. But unfortunately, I didn't get to have time. I kind of threw together what I could, so that's up on YouTube as well. So.
This is basically all you do when you're not skateboarding.
This is all I do, is I sit on this thing and talk to people back. Because I'm horrible. You've seen how bad I am at Facebook.